moment from the ASA Pro Tour. It's the professional circuit for rollerblading, the ASA Pro Tour, four stops across the country. The pros made their way to each event to measure up to see who would go the highest and who would pull the biggest tricks on both the street course and the vert ramp, earning rankings points all along the way. Some rivalries flourish. In this show, we're going to take a look at Eito Yasutoko and his incredible dominance throughout the 2003 season. We also get to hang out with Shane Yost and Cesar Moore.
How old are you? Are you supposed to be home right now? What's the curfew? Are you allowed to be drinking beer?
Fabiola Da Silva, the lone woman, had to make her way against the men, and she did just fine. Brian Aragon raised the bar on the street course, but many, many skaters gave him a run for his money, especially this guy, Stefan Alfano. Some incredible tricks from many of the world's best skaters out here on the street course.
Oh man, solid every time, it doesn't matter what he does.
And the vert ramp. We're gonna take a look and see who has a chance at the World Championships title and becoming the 2003 overall tour champion.
At last year's World Championships, Eito Yasutoko had to sit out. He was sidelined due to injury. His younger brother, Takeshi, who had been dominant all season long, flying higher than anyone else on the Pro Tour, had a clear path to the championships. With his older brother out of the way, Takeshi ran away with the World Championship and the number one ranking in the world. So Eito Yasutoko missing out on an opportunity to earn twice as many points at the Tour Championships has some serious work cut out for him as he tries to play catch up. And one of the guys standing in his way is Shane Yost.
Shane Yost, one of the most dynamic skaters up on the vert ramp, started the season off in incredible fashion. He took second at the first stop in Cincinnati, and he followed that up again with the second place in Milwaukee, where Cesar took third.
Shane Yost is a puzzle that's starting to come together now. Sketchy at first over the years, getting his style better, always had the big tricks, and I think this year is his best year so far.
Shane Yost, in my opinion, is the best vert skater in the world, and I say that because he has more tricks than anybody else.
Shane has so many different variations, almost no one can touch him. However, with so many big tricks, sometimes falling becomes his biggest weakness. He took sixth in Buffalo and then had a no-show in Dulles and dropped to fourth overall in the rankings.
I feel like I'm on a ski lift.
I hate to be in the middle of that right now. Look at you. That's like...
Can I get a double cheeseburger, please? With some fries would be great.
How old are you? Are you supposed to be home right now? What's the curfew? Are you allowed to be drinking beer?
Well, there at Summerfest, Cesar Mora came out gangbusters. Don't call it a comeback. Cesar Mora is definitely back. Taking third place at his first pro competition back from a year worth of injuries. Cesar Mora finally making his way back into the top 10 rankings.
He's back. Yeah.
The highest-ranked American skater, Mark Engelhardt, tries to protect his number two ranking going into Cincinnati. Despite some inconsistency, he earned a third-place finish, which kept him competitive. Mark has made it to the top of the rankings and managed to stay there on the strength of some incredible tricks. One of the few riders in the world who can throw the 1080, and he does it bigger and better than just about anyone else in the business. But in Milwaukee, he was only able to do well enough to place fourth. Buffalo had a much better showing and brought out a brand new trick, a brand new 900 variation, and skated his way into second place. Mark's strong performance had everybody talking about how far he could go on the Pro Tour and on into the World Championships.
I think Mark has the ingredients to be that guy, the number one guy out there. He proved that at Gravity Games last year when he pulled a perfect run and it came together. And what excites me about Mark is that America traditionally in recent years hasn't been known to produce, you know, world-class first skating. And I think, I'm hoping that with Mark being out there, being a good influence and competing on the level that he does, he's going to inspire a whole new generation.
Only a few short years ago, Fabiola Da Silva was skating in the women's division. She's been competing in the men's class for a couple years now.
I really admire it, you know. Goes into her tricks, comes out, just everything is just so graceful.
Graceful and technical, Fabiola Da Silva's been finishing consistently in the men's top 10, including sixth at the Gravity Games this year. Fabiola's got the perfect blend of technical coping tricks, big airs, and big tricks like the flat spin. When we come back, we're going to take a look at the two most dominant forces in the air, Takeshi and Eito Yasutoko. The Mobile Skate Park Series is brought to you by Yoohoo. Yoohoo or you don't. By Nestle Butterfinger. Break out of the ordinary and into a Butterfinger. By IDOS Backyard Wrestling. Don't try this at home. And by the LG Action Sports Championships, the year-end championships for skateboarding, BMX, freestyle motocross, and inline. Go to lgactionsports.com. Welcome back to the Mobile Skate Park Series and the ASA Pro Tour's best tricks and best moments from 2003.
Midnight, another movie and a glass of wine to get the feeling right. It's not the perfect moment, 'cause I've seen this one, but I still like the story. Then I start to close my eyes, so very soothing. The sound of white noise. After all, I've made it this far.
Well, it's no doubt who the best two vert riders in the world have been for a couple of seasons. Young Eito and Takeshi Yasutoko in 2002. Takeshi was the absolute undisputed most dominant skater, not only because of his huge amplitude, but also his ability on the coping. Once again, Takeshi came out throwing huge tricks this season, but had some trouble with some of the more technical tricks and lacked consistency at a couple of the events. His incredible talent still put him, though, in second place. He finished the season off a little bit frustrated in Washington, D.C., the last stop on the tour, because he couldn't land those coping tricks he's usually so consistent on. Eito Yasutoko came out at the first stop in Cincinnati, Ohio, and put together the perfect run.
We didn't see Eito last year at the World Championships, but you know he's been working on tricks in the off-season.
Eito blasting, already getting about 8 feet, almost 10 feet above the top of the coping. Last season, Takeshi had those big airs. Now, Eito's doing it as well. 1080 California roll.
And right off the bat, he's not wasting any time getting into that big trick. Showing off some lip tricks as he goes fish brain, kind of into the topside sole. And then double backflip, 180. We have not seen this trick before. A brand new trick from Eito. Oh my goodness, and what a whopper of a trick.
The double backflip 180 is the trick he learned here in Cincinnati just last season, but he hadn't been doing it in competition. Now he's got it.
My goodness, does he have it. Able to throw it in the middle of his run, and another double backflip finish run. What a combination. What a run of tricks from Eito Yasutoko.
Everybody's going to have their work cut out for them if they want to beat that.
No one can beat Eito Yasutoko.
At this point, it's going to be almost impossible.
I mean, he's just so consistent. He's got his lines down.
He knows how to put everything together.
He always, like, tricks, like, so high.
every trick too.
I mean, what can you say? The guy goes 13 feet out of a vert ramp on inline skates. There's nobody else doing that.
He doesn't care so much about winning or losing. He just wants to skate and get better and better.
He's the best.
Well, Ato took first place in Cincinnati, in Milwaukee, in Buffalo, and D.C., and only because he wasn't at last year's championships is he ranked number 3 in the world. But you can expect him to try to be the number 1 after this year's championships.
When we come back, we're going to switch gears and move to the gritty on street.
Welcome back to the best tricks of the 2003 ASA Pro Tour season. Before you break, I've already broken down. Taking a look at some of the up-and-comers, guys that have either been on the tour for 1 or 2 years, or they're brand new. Blake O'Brien always taking a creative look at the course.
Blake known for spinning into those Farfignugan variations, not afraid to take some chances.
I don't know, I just like to do all the tricks, try to learn all the tricks. And I try to worry about making the tricks like look to my liking mostly.
Well, he pulled enough great tricks throughout the season to be currently ranked number 4 in the world going into the championships.
Bobby Tatiishi made his way onto the Pro Tour in his rookie season. Showed that his time on the M circuit paid off. Very good at putting lines together, big spins and technical combos, made him the highest ranked rookie by the end of the regular season.
One of the many very talented skaters out of Utah on the street, Cameron Card.
Cameron Card is one of my favorite skaters and one of my best friends. He has a great style. He's a great street skater, great at park. He's just fun to watch. Everything's smooth and perfect.
Cameron's racked up one win, and he also brings a more technical side to the course, but he's not afraid at all to go big.
Richie Velasquez is somewhat of an anomaly as a rookie. He's 27 years old, he's a father, and he's the camp director at Woodward West, but he's in his first season on the Pro Tour and making the most of it. Already known for being one of the most exciting skaters on the tour and coming through in big trick contests.
Now, taking a look at some of the guys that have been absolutely dominating over the years, Blake Dennis, last year's world champion and the number one ranked skater in the world.
Blake Dennis is really good. Trick after trick after trick, his style, just really smooth style, and just always doing tricks, tricks, tricks.
Blake takes a creativity to the course, knows how to put together great lines.
Another former world champion, Jaron Grobe, no stranger to the winner's podium, had some trouble with consistency this season on the tour.
Jaron Grobe, he's the monster, as everybody knows. Goes big, doesn't give a nothing about nothing. That's what I like about Jaron, is that he gives it his 100% every time he gets out there.
Jaron continued that legacy this year by going bigger than just about anyone on the court.
Ben Bokhorst, also a former world champion, has not made it to many events this season, but when he does show up, he does very well for himself, winning the X Games Global Championships. But he spent most of the season focusing on his studies back home in Holland.
Sven finished the season 18th heading into the championships, and here's a guy who won the world championships back in 1997 and now is knocking in the top 10 ranking once again.
A perennial favorite, Randy Roadhouse Spicer, staying competitive all these years.
Another one who had a great couple moments this year, John Julio, bringing that signature style. He was one of the early innovators on the street course, making a top 5 finish this season.
Ryan Dawe has finished as high as number 2 in the world ranking in years past.
Anything Ryan Dawe does, I like how he does it because he goes everything with speed. He just adds his own style to it.
You come on, look my way. One of the most dominant skaters for years, Aaron Feinberg, former X Games gold medalist, world champion, and number one ranked skater, came out with that signature style, so many difficult tricks, and made his mark during the season. Unfortunately, got injured mid-season and will not be in the World Championships.
After some time away from the competition circuit, former X Games champion Nicky Adams re-emerged and won the first best trick contest he entered.
The contest was great, man. I mean, everybody was going off, and I feel great, you know? I feel good, you know? I came back, first ASA stop, win a best trick. Can't get any better than that, you know? I did what I had to do, and I'm happy about it.
Nicky Adams, everybody's got big expectations of him heading into the championships, and Carl Hills has really come on this season as well.
He's a veteran on the vert scene, and he's made significant strides this season on the Pro Tour, making some history with the 1260 on street.
The first ever 1260 in a competition run earns Carl Hills this week's LG Pick Trick. You can log on for your favorite pick trick. To vote for your favorite pick trick, log on to lgactionsports.com, and the overall winner will be determined at the LG Action Sports Championships. Carl Hills nails it on the street course, and on the vert ramp, Marco DeSanti with the double flat spin, the trick that helped him take a top three finish at the Gravity Game. The overall winner is going to be determined at the LG Action Sports Championships, the season-ending championships of Action Sports, November 15th to the 23rd in Los Angeles. When we come back, more of the best on the street here at the ASA Pro Tour. Born to Play by Paul Mitchell. Paul Mitchell is all about style, your style. And by proud sponsors of the LG Action Sports Championships, Toyota, get the feeling. And by Timex, life is ticking. In 2002, two young rookies, Brian Aragon and Stefan Alfano, emerged and were going back to back, battling all season long, fighting for that Rookie of the Year title. This season, that rivalry has continued, but this time they've been fighting for the number one ranking each week.
In Cincinnati, Stefan Alfano came out with his signature style, huge tricks and very difficult, dangerous lines, only to lose out to Brian Aragon.
Brian Aragon is so good because his technical level is as high as anyone's, his air level is as high as anyone's, everything is at the peak.
Brian Aragon, I met him at Camp Iceberg. I can't believe I was trying to teach the kid how to skate. I was like, are you serious? By the second week, he was already the advanced instructor. We knew that he was going to be great.
Stefan Alfano and Brian Aragon have similar styles. They both bring big tricks to the course, and they both skate exceptionally fast.
Brian puts everything together. He really does the turn over the box, but then he'll also do the 360 topsail. You know, he's tech and he skates training really well.
And with those talents, he finished the first two stops with gold medal.
Every contest, I'm first place for the prelim, and for the final, I lose some place. So I hope I stay in the first place for the ranking. But yeah, Brian Aragon, he's good skating too, so I don't know.
On to stop three, and Stefano Fano was trying to ensure that he would hold on to his number one ranking after the prelim.
Every contest that I go to, Stefan Alfano is always amazing to watch. He's just so good, and he's pretty well-rounded, and just watching him skate is just amazing. Sometimes I can't even believe the tricks he's doing, but I guess he pushes me to try harder tricks, and he's better than me in the spinning aspect, and I think I'm better in the grinding aspect, so I try to focus on that as much as I can and work with my strength while he works with his.
Both skaters put together fantastic runs and some huge tricks, but once again, Brian Aragon came out on top. Three wins in a row.
At the final stop of the season in Washington, D.C., Brian Aragon came out with all his big tricks, the difficult grinds and the huge spins as he tried to make it four in a row.
Let's not talk about him anymore because he's so good.
Unfortunately, as Aragon tried to raise the bar, he took some spills and it cost him the number one spot, but he still finished ahead of his arch rival, Stefan Alfano, taking second to Stefan third. And so the stage is set for an epic battle at the World Championships between the number one and number two ranked riders in the world.
Well, with big tricks, you always take the risk at a big spill. Nicky Adams made such an impact the first time he came out, but he also took some big wrecks on the way getting there. This is Yu's best wrecks. The stage is now set. So many riders, so much momentum, all leading up to the LG Action Sports Championships and the ASA Pro Tour World Championships. All the best riders are going to be there. It takes place November 15th through the 23rd. It's the year-end championships for inline skating, where all these guys will be competing, and the U.S. Championship for skateboarding, BMX, and the World Championship for FMX. You don't want to miss it. Go to lgactionsports.com and check out all the information. It's going to be in Pomona, California, November 15th to the 23rd. Keep track of all your favorite riders from all the sports. Keep watching 4 to 5 every Friday here on Fox Sports Net. Or go to mssevent.com.